You know who we haven't talked about in a while? Cole Caulfield. That was always the throwback, wasn't it? All the videos we made talking about his college games and the hat tricks he would endlessly score every weekend. That was the thing in 20... When the heck was that? 2019? 2020? Yeah, no, he was drafted in 2019, right. So we kind of did the entire Caulfield update Wisconsin thing in 2020, 2021. But it's been a while. So I think just for old time's sake, let's make a video talking about Cole Caulfield, just review his season in its entirety, and also go over a few quotes from Nick Suzuki talking about Caulfield and where he would like to see the team go with the Caulfield contract negotiations, etc., etc. So, Caulfield, at this point in time, still is a short guy. He's 5'7". I mean, I'm one to talk, I'm 5'3", so I think that's kind of why I've always had an intrinsic bias towards shorter players. But as a 5'7", 165-pound right winger with a right-handed shot, he went out there in 2021-2022 and scored 43 points in 67 games played. Now, his 23-goal year certainly is not bad when you just look at the regular numbers, but when you acknowledge the extreme difference in production between Dominique Ducharme and Marty St. Louis, it becomes a lot more easy to say that Caulfield had a much more talented skill set than the numbers 43 points in 67 games would necessarily indicate. That's all fine and dandy, though, and we all know the impact that Caulfield had on this team. He had 5 goals in his last 10 games in the regular season. He actually had 5 goals in his last 5 games in the regular season. So, there you go, goal-scoring machine Cole Caulfield coming back out here to end off the year on a high note. But when it comes to Nick Suzuki, he is another guy on this team that has been pretty linked to Caulfield when it comes to discourse about the future of the Habs. You always talk about, oh, it's Caulfield and Suzuki, Caulfield and Suzuki. These guys are going to be the sniper and the playmaker. It's the dynamic duo over here. Now, with Shane Wright entering the mix, things might be a little bit more complicated, and we'll get into that as this video goes on. But for Nick Suzuki, he was the cream of the crop this season for the Montreal Canadiens, 61 points in 82 games played. The big thing with Nick is that he has already signed his huge contract extension, $7.875 million a year, which will take him until the end of 2030. It's no secret that he is going to be a huge part of the Canadiens going into the long-term future, and I mean, it's only natural that he would want to see somebody else of his same status, like Cole Caulfield, also lock down somewhat of a similar deal. This is what Nick Suzuki said during the Montreal Sports Celebrity Breakfast. There's no better place to play than Montreal. I hope Cole signs a long-term deal with us. Now, he said this right beside Cole Caulfield, the Montreal, what is it called, the Celebrity Breakfast? It's an interesting event, and you had yourselves a few other events here and there with Caulfield and Suzuki greeting the fans and seeing people out on the street, taking pictures with kids and everything. It's been cool just seeing how these players are getting involved with the community. Obviously, that's a great plus. But you also had this quote here on The Athletic. This is what Nick Suzuki said about his friendship and chemistry with Cole Caulfield. I think right away, when Cole came to the team, we clicked right away on and off the ice. We love hanging out with each other, playing with each other. Just to build that chemistry for the last couple of years and moving forward, hopefully Cole signs a long-term deal with us. Just to play with him is really special. We have a ton of fun together and hopefully we can win a few cups just like the older guys. Now, I'm not sure what he means by the older guys. Does he mean like, okay, Henri Richard? That guy won a lot of cups. Let's win a lot of cups like that guy. The Pocket Rocket and his Rocket Richard older brother. Let's win a whole bunch of cups like those guys, the older guys. Or if he's talking about, I don't know, some other older players in the NHL like Nikita Kucherov or Victor Hedman. Those guys have won a few cups together too. But just seeing this, you know, I read this quote and I was thinking, do I want to make a video about that? Like, obviously, it's just one small quote. It's Nick Suzuki saying, oh, I want Caulfield to sign long term. But, like, we've been so focused on the draft the past few weeks, talking about Slavkovsky and Wright, and there was another conversation that Kent Hughes went out there and said, where he's like, yeah, I don't know who we're going to take, guys. Oh, boy, I'm going to spoil the draft, like, weeks before it happens, where tickets are $600 or whatever it is in Montreal. Like, we've been talking so much about the draft that I think there should be a little bit more breathing room to just sit back and say, huh, we've already got some really good players. Like, Cole Caulfield is here. We were making videos every weekend about this guy last year, talking about his hat tricks with the Wisconsin Badgers and how he was amazing, and how he had the Hobie Baker and all this crazy stuff. And this guy's still here. He's got 1 year left at $800,000 before the Canadiens would sign him to an extension. And I'll say would because we know what's going to happen. Like, there's no way Caulfield doesn't re-sign. Ken Hughes is not going to let that happen. The question is, though, what kind of contract does he sign? And that's kind of the interesting thing here, because honestly, like, if you're asking me today, I don't think it's in Caulfield's best interest to sign a long-term deal now, in the summer, heading into his RFA-eligible year. Because for Cole Caulfield, we all kind of know that his 21-22 was not the best, especially compared to what it could have been had he been under St. Louis the entire time. Like, I don't have it in front of me right now, but the guy had one goal in 20-something games under Ducharme. He had 22 goals in the last however many games to end off the year, scoring at a 40-goal pace or whatever it was. If you were to sign Caulfield to a long-term contract extension today, the first thing Kent Hughes is going over is, hey, your 21-22 production. You had 43 points in 67 games played. We think you can get better by X amount, which is why we'll offer you, let's say, $7 million. But let's say Cole Caulfield accepts this. He signs 8 years, seven-ish million dollars, and then next year he goes out there and he actually scores 35 goals. Like, that's not impossible, is it? Cole Caulfield, especially playing with one of Suzuki and or Wright, scoring 35 goals and let's say 30 assists for 60-something total points on the year. If you get this guy at 22 years old, scoring 35 goals and 60 points on a season, all of a sudden his long-term projectability is a lot higher than that of a $7 million price tag. It seems to me like this is something that Caulfield himself should probably sit on, because if he does get that 60-point season, that 35-goal season at 22 years old, then it's easier for him to say, hey, I scored this amount of goals, pay me 8, pay me 8.5. If he scores 40 or 45 goals, he can say, hey, pay me 9. Like, there's a lot of potential here with this player, and I think everybody kind of knows that. It's no longer a fact of him being small that is holding him back from this discourse that says that he's a good player. We know how skilled Caulfield is, and playing with one of Suzuki or Wright, it's gonna make things very interesting when you take a look at who should be his center long term. This is a conversation that I saw pop up on Twitter. MusMus99 tweeted this out on Twitter the other day, saying that they've not been sold on the Suzuki and Caulfield duo. They get crushed at 5v5, and I'm pretty sure Caulfield has assisted more Suzuki goals than Suzuki has on Caulfield goals, which isn't really how it's supposed to work. Wright should be Caulfield's center long-term. We then had a reply actually going over the hard numbers. Last season, 8 of Caulfield's 23 goals featured either a primary or secondary assist by Suzuki. Meanwhile, 8 of Suzuki's 21 goals featured a primary or secondary assist by Caulfield. Percentage-wise, Caulfield has assisted on a slightly higher percent of Suzuki's goals. However, the difference in percentages is very small. As for even strength versus power play scoring, 8 of the combined 16 goals were at even strength, and the other 8 were on the power play. Unsurprisingly, Suzuki assists on more of Caulfield's even strength goals, while Caulfield assists on more of Suzuki's power play goals. And so, the hard numbers about it kind of suggest a picture that we're all sort of familiar with. Okay, Caulfield gets more points on Suzuki goals on the power play, Suzuki gets more points on Caulfield goals at even strength. Just based off of how these two play, it makes a lot of sense to analyze the game in that way. But whether or not Shane Wright comes in here and absolutely breaks the walls down and shows off that he's a better playmaker at both 5v5 and power play time than Suzuki, it's going to be interesting to see where that goes, right? I think that Marty St. Louis is smart enough as a hockey person, as a head coach, to go out there and make the right decisions here. Heck, if the Canadiens take Slavkovsky, which I'm only going to entertain for this little 30 seconds right here, if Slavkovsky's the guy, you can just go Suzuki, Caulfield, Slavkovsky, right? Oh man, there's a lot of assonance in that little line that I like a lot. Suzuki, Caulfield, Slavkovsky, ooh, that sounds very nice. For Shane Wright, though, obviously you're going to have to make one or the other your number one and your number two, so it's going to be somewhat of a task to find that winger to replace Caulfield and his production, assuming you move Caulfield away from Suzuki. And if you keep Suzuki and Caulfield together, then it's like, okay, well, you need somebody to play with Shane Wright. Is Josh Anderson that guy? I'm not too sure. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below about this entire Caulfield talk, the quotes from Suzuki, the long-term contract, the monetary side of things. Do you agree with my idea here that it kind of would be better for Caulfield to sign a long-term deal next year rather than this year, mostly because of the inefficiencies of his regular season in 21-22? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Trolls 99. And bye.